Let's go outside. The snow is falling down and every child is having so much fun. The snowman is twice the size as me with a smile.
Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing well. Please excuse my rain here. I was all ready to film this video, had to go to an appointment and come back, and I got caught in the rain and this happened. But today's video is going to be all about Oliver's Christmas Eve box. I have done a really, really simple DIY and really inexpensive DIY actually to make a Christmas Eve box for him, and I'm going to show you also what I put inside. Again, it's really, really inexpensive. Most of the things are from Pound Shop. First of all, I'm going to talk about the DIY side of it and how to make it. I thought this was a good day to put this up because it's right before the weekend. It's the 21st of December. So if you're wanting to do a Christmas Eve box like this, then you can definitely do it over the weekend. It's not going to take a lot of time. And as I said, it costs barely anything. So this is it here. It is a really, really simple design. I always go for things that are like wooden and hessian fabric greenery at Christmas time. I just think a really simple design is lovely. So Oliver's Christmas Eve box just says Christmas Eve box on it. It has this little bell and bow, a little bit of Christmas tree and some little bells on the side, and the box itself is from IKEA. All I did was obviously build the box from IKEA. These are only £5 for these little crates, and then for the lettering I used wooden letters from The Works, and you can get a full pack of them for £3. I think it's £3 or £3.99. I was going to personalise it, but the way it worked out with space and stuff, it just looked better just to have it saying Christmas Eve box. And I just sprayed this with some gold spray paint from B&M, which was £2.99, and then stuck it on with some super glue. Super simple. This part of the design is actually a door hanger from Poundland, and all I did was take it apart. It had hanging bells on the back of it, and it had a little circle at the top which I just removed, and then the hanging bells I have tied on the sides here, which I think is really, really cute, and I just super glued on the bow with the pine and the little holly berries. And there was actually a little bit of glue that you could still see on this just because it's a Poundland item, so I put another one of the bells over there too. And that is it. Very, very simple Christmas Eve box, but I think it's really, really cute. So now I'm going to show you what is going in the Christmas Eve box and what I've chosen. Oliver is 2 years and 3 months, I think. 2 years, 2 months. So I wanted to make his Christmas Eve box more about activities to do on Christmas Eve. We've made a point this year of making sure that all the presents are wrapped. There's no panic buying on Christmas Eve so that we can just have a nice day. Christmas Eve is all about just chilling out, having fun. And I thought I would give this little Christmas Eve box just to keep Oliver occupied. I also have this thing where I feel like he's just going to be so overwhelmed on Christmas Day with presents that I'm trying to kind of give him things gradually. I've gave him a couple of his toys already, and there's a few things in here that I was going to give to him on Christmas Day. I have decided not to do a stocking this year because I just think it's too much. So some of the things that I'd bought for his stocking I've just put in the Christmas Eve box, and he can use it on the day just to have a really fun, exciting day. So let me show you what we've got. So the first thing is a pound. This is from Poundland. It is just a little wobbly eyes colouring pad, and it's got these little googly eyes on it. He has only just started getting into colouring in like very recently. Another thing that I want to do during the day and to start like a bit of a Christmas tradition is to bake. So we are going to make muffins. I got this from B&M, and it's one of these little jars that have all the ingredients for chocolate chip muffins. It looks really good. All you do is add, I think it's just eggs and milk. You add milk, eggs and butter, mix up and put it in the oven, and we will have some nice freshly baked muffins on Christmas Eve, which I am so looking forward to. This was £2.99. I feel like I'm saying everything's £2 or £3, but this was about £2 from B&M, and yeah, hopefully they're gonna be good. The next thing is one of his stocking fillers, which is just going in the Christmas Eve box now, and it is this little torch from Poundland. Oliver is obsessed with turning our lights on and off, so I think it'll be really exciting for him to have a tiny little torch of his own. He will find that really fun. By the way, a lot of these things are mentioned in my Poundland stocking fillers video, so I'm going to leave that linked below if you want to check it out. These are just some little animals which I got from Poundland. So these are just to go in his bath at night time. He loves like little things like this to play with in the bath. I think he'll have a really nice bath, fun bath on Christmas Eve. I also have this new little book for him, which is Head, Shoulders, Knees and Toes. I got this from Costco. It was going to go in with his Christmas presents, but he actually does have some other books and I don't want to do too much with the books on Christmas Day. So I thought I'll give him this one the night before. It's not Christmas themed, but I didn't really see the point of getting a Christmas themed one that's going to be out of date within like 24 hours. So I just got him this little Head and Shoulders book. And Head, Shoulders, Knees and Toes, not dandruff. And it's got... Why did I press that? Obviously I had to put some sweets in there, so I've got him a little Santa lolly and these little chocolate reindeers from Home Bargains. Oliver barely ever has chocolate, like literally hardly ever has chocolate, so I'm going to say he's probably going to have one of these and I'll have the rest. That's the most likely outcome. And last but not least, I have this other tiny little book which I got from Poundland, and it's my first 1, 2, 3, and it's just lots of little pictures of different fruits and things. I think that'll help with his speech as well, because obviously I can point to things and tell him what they're called. I think that's actually a really good little book for £1. The very last thing hasn't actually been set up yet. I took it out of the plastic and everything the other night, but we are in need of those tiny little screwdrivers to put batteries in. It's so annoying because you usually get them in crackers and we're not going to have that until Christmas Day. So I'm going to have to get Andy to try and source one of those tiny, tiny little screwdrivers so that I can use that. But this is from B&M. It was £3, funnily enough, and it is a little disco light for your bath. So you stick it on anywhere under the water and it'll light your bath up, obviously turn the lights out, and it does like a little disco thing. So it's another thing for a fun bath on Christmas Eve. I haven't put some of the typical things in this Christmas Eve box, partly because of his age. So I've not put in jammies because it's not like a novelty thing for him. He doesn't get excited over jammies. He does have one pair of Christmas jammies, but he's been wearing them a lot because I wanted him to get the most out of it. So he's been wearing them throughout December, and things like hot chocolate and all of that, he doesn't drink. So we don't have any of the basic things that most people have in a Christmas Eve box, but we can do that in years to come when it's not, the novelty of it isn't going to be lost on him. So I really hope you've enjoyed watching this video. If you're doing a Christmas Eve box for your little one, then let me know what you're putting in yours, because I will need some ideas for next year. And next year I'll actually have to make another one of these for the baby, which is quite exciting. So thanks very much for watching this video. I hope you've enjoyed it. But don't forget to head over to Instagram. I'll leave my little thing here so you can follow me on Instagram as well. And don't forget to give the video a thumbs up and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.